What did you think about doing online school during the pandemic?
I hated it.
Are you back to in-person school now?
Yeah.
Do you like that better when you're in a classroom? You got kids, you got friends, yeah. Teachers. Okay, so school is just, it doesn't matter if it's online or if it's in person, school is just.
School sucks.
Sucks.
I agree
with
that.
It's the worst. I pick myself up just to fall back down. I hurt myself when no one's around. You don't know who you are when you're standing in the dark.
So last time I saw you guys to chat with you was at Emo Nite Vegas. And yes. I think that was your guys' first show back, like since the pandemic, maybe? South I go!
It was our first.
And the second.
No, I think it was the first.
I think so.
And this time, I've only been drinking water because last time, it was I was just running around the microphone, and I actually had to cut parts of that chat when I put on my little podcast because. Specifically us. Oh,
I'm
Justin,
so sorry.
It was rough
I'm
to
so
go
sorry.
Back and listen to.
I still have a headache from
I
that
do
night.
Too. Yeah. I haven't had a drink of anything other than water since then.
I've been only drinking coconut water.
Yeah, it's a good.
Actually, congratulations,
man. I have some really good footage of you from that night because I was filming on my phone.
Oh, yeah, because you had your, yeah.
I have some good stuff.
And it made
I'll
it into the vlog. I saw a quick clip because you've been vlogging. You're still doing that, yeah?
Yeah, but I had to cut a lot of it because it was.
I'm so sorry.
It was a lot for audiences to handle.
Yeah, it was too much. But how's the tour been, guys? I was out at the show at 1720, and it was a party. I was in the crowd losing my mind the entire time because I love to lose my mind when my friends are on stage doing their thing. So you guys are finally back out on the road. What's it been like after, 2 years?
It's been a blast. It's been what I've been saying like on stage is that there's this new energy, I think, because music went away for a second. And I think that people realize how important music is. Mm-hmm. So for the bands, it's super important. Like it's never been before. It's almost like, you know, your first show or your first tour again. And for the fans, they've just been electric. It's been amazing to be a part of, and every show has been fantastic. So
I got to introduce Copeland is here, by the way. I got it.
Hello, Copeland.
Hello. Welcome to the chat. And you, how was it, Kellin? You got to spend more time in the past few years with your kid. So how was that for you guys? Did you like having your dad home so much during the pandemic?
Yes.
It's nice. Yeah, I think I realize how important it is to be present in your life. And I realize there's a lot of things that I was missing just constantly touring to stay afloat. And one of the things that the pandemic taught me is that you don't have to tour yourself into the ground to, you know, have a life or to make a living. And I mean, it was stressful at some moments in time to just figure it all out, but it was worth it because I got to be with you and mom and the boys, and we got to spend a lot of time together.
And how is it for all of you guys? Because you've all been touring for like so much of your lives that I'd imagine for all of you that was the biggest downtime. And I would imagine it was probably needed to an extent after your whole life is pretty much on the road nonstop.
It was definitely needed. But I do think the pandemic was especially difficult for me, for sure. Mm-hmm. I mean, it was difficult for everybody. But I definitely went through a lot personally because, yeah, touring nonstop, you even love it or hate it, it's a big part of our lives. It's like it's in our like lifeblood. It's like what we do. So to have that taken away, it was tough for me. It was really tough. But I think it got tough because we would like book some tours and then it'd be like, all right, we're going back out. And then the pandemic kind of got worse and worse. It was going through these ups and downs. We were canceling tours and we were rebooking them. And then we had to push those back. And it was this constant just wondering, like, are we ever going to go back? It really felt like it was never going to happen again. Uh-huh. And so it was tough, but it was a great time for self-reflection and get into a better mental headspace. So I use that in a positive way for sure.
Yeah, I also lost like 15 pounds.
Yeah, Kellin looks great.
You like, do.
Copeland, when I first got home, she's like, I could put my cereal bowl on your stomach and it's like a table. Do you remember that?
I do not.
She's like, Dad, I could put my cereal bowl on your stomach and it stays because it's like a table. So I was like, damn, I better get into the gym.
I lost 40 pounds
wow.
during the pandemic, which was wild.
Yeah.
When I looked back now, I was like, I didn't realize how big I was getting, I guess. But that was one of the best things that I, because the first part of it, I was definitely, I feel like a lot of people were probably just drinking too much.
We were all making,
it went either way. Either you put on a lot of weight or you got really healthy.
That's true. Yeah. Going to the gym and running and doing all those things is not necessarily about losing the weight, although that is like a benefit. To me, it's like mental health. There's something about just having that time to yourself. Like when I can go out and run for like 4 miles and just put in music that I want to listen to, it's just, it's nice. It's like you need that, you know. Mm-hmm. It's given me 2 more abs, and it's given me it's given me 2 more abs than I've had before, and then it's also given me some iron lungs.
Yeah, so you can and I'm sure that's good now that you're back on stage.
It's
it's a workout.
I think it's also important too to just like step away from what we were doing. Like Kellin said, we were doing it so much. Like for me, it was like something where I just wanted to like learn and like get a new hobby. You know, and like learn something new and like start fresh.
What did you pick anything in particular up?
Not in particular, just a lot of like, you know, like things at home. Like, you know, I built a dirt bike, like, you know, just things like that. Like
that's a big deal, dude.
Yeah, but it's just like the same thing. It's like a mental thing. Like, you know, you're not going out. You know, we're not going back on tour for at least, you know, 3 months
however
or
long.
6 months, whatever, yeah. You know, as the information was coming in. But, you know, and you just kind of had to like take it and just run with it, you know? So, it was, you know, it's weird also like having to find other ways to work and make money and stuff like that, because who saves money for a pandemic, mm-hmm. you know? But, I don't know. I think it built a lot of character in all of us.
And I did just see your new custom dirt bike boots, I think.
Those blue ones. They're actually coming today.
They are pretty. Yeah. And you also like
cotton candy blue.
Cotton candy blue. And you like snowboarding as well, right?
I do.
Because I always grew up snowboarding.
Because
I'm from Reno, which is right near Lake Tahoe.
Yeah.
So that's where I've always gone. I saw that you were up at Snowmass this last season. And I love that whole area, all the mountains up
Let's
there.
Let's go this year.
You guys, we should go up to Tahoe sometime. My parents have a house up there. And me and my friends
I
were just there
it.
Last
yeah.
weekend.
I would love it, too. Yeah,
I'm down.
Oh, in the winter and in the summer, because you cannot beat the two seasons in Lake Tahoe.
It's the best, right?
It's so sick.
Should we just go right now? What are we doing?
Come on, guys. Let's go. Run up to Tahoe. That was a cool set.
Hey, Copeland, what did you think about doing online school during the pandemic?
I hated it.
But wasn't your dad? You got to be a bit of a teacher, though, right, Kellin?
I'm not a good teacher, am I?
Teacher.
I don't hear the sincerity in that voice.
I feel like I lose my patience. Yeah. I'm not built to be a teacher.
Are you back to in-person school now?
Yeah.
Do you like that better when you're in a classroom? You got kids, you got friends, teachers. No. Okay, so school is just, it doesn't matter if it's online or if it's in person. School is just.
Yeah, school sucks.
It sucks.
I agree
with
that.
It's the worst.
School.
What do you think about, like, what if you were doing online school but you got to go on tour all the time? Would you do that?
Yeah. How many shows are you out for?
She has one more after this.
Nice. And I heard that you went out to Emo Nite out in New York. Is that where it was? Did you have fun? Because Emo Nite is such a blast.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How do you do that thing with your eye?
I have a lazy eye. And sometimes I can control it, and sometimes it just does it. You hear that, you guys? She's calling me out for having a
lazy
eye.
Leave it up to the kids,
man.
Yes.
Sorry.
I've had two surgeries on it. But you ready for this? Here's some eye stuff. So we can go like this.
Whoa.
And then we go like that.
Wow.
That's why it does that.
That is a
pretty
talent.
Either one lazy.
Oh.
So I was just born with it naturally. You know, it's just my signature trait.
And you got to own it.
Yeah, you got to own it. I got to own it. And then, the first time I was filming a web series with Tommy over here, and I was acting in it for him.
Why DeLong face? You get it?
I get it. It's Tom DeLong. Blink-182.
Yeah, dude.
And then he was like, Kunit, can you stop doing that thing with your eye this time? But like, it's you're doing.
Dude, I've never noticed.
And then so I've known you for years.
Yeah.
I've known Copeland for 10 minutes, and she picked up on it.
So very observant.
So very observant.
And no filter.
No filter. But I appreciate it because now the world knows. But you guys, you got new music coming out. You've dropped 2 new songs, which are so good. Oh my God,
thank
you guys.
You.
And this is obviously an album that's been written amidst the pandemic. And was it your first album that you've recorded with the guys?
Yeah.
Yeah, I know you can't tell where I'm looking.
Personally, yeah.
But it was
I got you. We had the deluxe edition for How It Feels to Be Lost.
Yeah, that's right.
I've done a couple of songs on that. And this is the first full length that I've been a part of.
Nice, that's exciting.
And it's been a trip. It's really exciting. And I can honestly say it's some of the best work that I've ever put forward and that Sirens have, I reckon. Because I've been worked with the guys for a long time in different bands and have been a fan of their records too. And it seems like it's the perfect blend between a number of their records, so it's going to be an exciting cycle.
Yeah, I've been kind of saying that if you like madness, let's hang the jury, you sick judgmental fools. If you like Let's Cheers, well, I never thought you'd stay. That's okay. If you like the previous record, How It Feels to Be Lost, you think you're better than me, you don't. And sprinkle a little bit of the first album on there. It's like all those kind of mixed together. Mm-hmm. And it was kind of like an unconscious idea, but it was kind of conscious at the same time. As we were like making it and we were like doing songs, we're like, wow, this kind of reminds me of like this album, or it kind of reminds me of that in like a positive way, you know? It almost feels like it's a little throwback to a lot of things, but with like a modern twist on it.
Yeah, and you had this on Crosses Drop. You guys got some Under Oath. Jumping
Under
on
Oath.
That one. When you're watching, this mess might be my coffin. I care
too much, but now you think I've had enough. Dude, Spencer
Crazy.
Really came out swinging on that
he
one.
He was so yeah. good in it. And yeah. I loved it because he was really, I feel like, because sometimes like there's the features where someone pops in for a couple seconds and then they're out. But once he popped in, he was in the whole song.
Yeah.
Which was so sick. And the video
was
awesome.
I like doing features like that because it seems, if I'm going to give like a part away, like you got to be like, you know, in the song, you know, because I don't like giving vocal parts away.
Yeah,
he does it.
I really don't. So I think every feature that's on this record, and this is probably the album that has the most, other than Feel, I think is probably the other one that had like the most. But
yeah, well, you got Royal, you've got
Charlotte Sands
and Dorothy. Is that Dorothy? What? I'm not familiar with that.
So she's just a rock singing powerhouse.
Nice.
And
her voice is crazy.
Her voice is crazy. You can't hang your chains on me. When you're 6 feet deep, this heart ain't yours to bleed. Now that yours no longer beats. So she is on a song called Us, and we have Spencer, and I think that's it, yeah? Just the four?
Yeah.
Am I missing anything?
I think that's right. I was trying to.
Charlotte.
I did say Charlotte, yeah.
Yeah. And, so are the two songs that are out now, because the other one's Bloody Knuckles, which, Damon, I remember you loved Bloody Knuckles when it came out.
I did.
And I remember even, Damon, you were like, this sounds like, we were driving out home from Hollywood one day, and he was like, this sounds like a song that should be, like, on the radio. Yeah! We bought a one-way ticket because we're sick of it all. Back to bags, we're going at the bottom, but we got no reason to lay down. Like you care anyway, no.
Aw,
like, it's just such a clean, good-sounding song.
Love that song.
And are the two, because they're both heavier songs.
Yeah, they're both heavier songs.
Is the whole album kind of similar to that?
Where are you going?
She's out of here.
If you want to come back, you're more than welcome.
Is that okay?
But so is that kind of reflective of sonically what the album is going to be sounding like? Because I love it. It's so big.
Yeah,
and just
I mean,
awesome.
You've heard more songs than just the two.
So the time that I did, though, it was in Vegas last year.
Yes, so you don't remember.
I don't remember.
Okay.
Me
I remember
either.
You loving them, though. I remember each one that came on. You're like, I like this one better than the last one.
Yeah, because there was a shot in between each one.
Okay.
And it just kept getting better and
that's
better.
That's right. We played you a bunch of the record. I forgot about
that. Yeah, we were jamming that in the room, and it was awesome. So from what I recall, I think that it was good.
It is good. I think I can't say that it's all heavy like that, but it's definitely not like, here's two heavy songs, now the rest are acoustic. It's not going to be anything like that. I think that, like I said, if you like those albums that I mentioned previously, then you're going to love it because there's a good mix of everything.
That's awesome.
Which is great because I think that some of our fans don't want every song to have like a breakdown or be super heavy, you know? So there's something for everyone.
I do think there is another song on the record that is heavier than the
two
songs.
There's two more that are heavier.
Oh, yeah.
Control Alt Delete is way heavier.
So that's what the tour is named after, but no one's even heard the song.
It's coming.
Correct. It's coming.
So, but not during the tour, obviously, right?
Maybe. Exclusive. Cut to an exclusive clip of the song, Control Alt Delete. Upside down.
So that's a heavy one?
Yeah. It's heavy, yeah.
Nice.
It's super heavy.
And it's just a fast, just like straight to the point one.
Who did you guys work with on this, producer-wise?
Andrew Bayless and Zach Cervini.
Nice. Zach Cervini. Nice. Yeah. No Matt Good this time?
No Matt Good this time. No. It just didn't work out. But we love working with Matt, and we would love to work with Matt again.
And I know because you guys were on drugs.
Yep.
And
yes,
I'm
we were.
Such a from first to last fan.
Did you spill?
Same.
And that's why I love that you guys were at 1720, because Travis owns that venue.
Does he? I didn't even know
yeah,
that.
Yeah, he's one of the owners of it.
What a trip.
So
I
was just like, oh, it's a full circle from first to last everywhere.
Wow, that is so crazy.
I didn't know that.
Yeah. So he's been killing.
Was he there?
No, because okay. I've been trying to find him because I love the bathroom there, and I'm trying to figure out if I can rent it out for Tommy to film a short movie at. So, but
gotcha.
It's got a great bathroom there.
I think we filmed some things in that bathroom actually.
Oh, did you?
Did we you
did.
Film some things
we
in the
did.
Bathroom at the LA venue?
Yes.
Oh, nice. I look forward to seeing your bathroom videos.
Don't get caught up in the love.
A party back yeah. here. She's literally oh, and I'm sure you can see her behind me actually, because
oh,
I got
this
camera back
here.
Going
on the whole time.
Yeah.
So,
so that's some good stuff. But Nick, I know you kicked off a coffee brand.
I did.
How
yeah.
did how did this come to be? Charlie Royal. Yep. You got John Taffer to freaking review it.
This company is a great company that sent me all this coffee, Charlie Royal coffee. Wow, that is excellent coffee.
How does one get in? Because I'm a coffee addict. Yesterday, yeah. or before your guys' show, I had 6 cans of cold brew that day.
Six cans, wow.
And Damon can attest to it that I was not having a good. When we showed up there, I was like, wait, I have like a lot of anxiety and my heart is racing. I probably
Dude, that's
had.
A lot of caffeine.
Yeah, I know.
I drink a lot of coffee, but you take the cake right
I,
there.
I could have probably overdosed on it. But what led you to wanting to create a coffee brand? Because that's unexpected.
Yeah, that was like 5 or 6 years in like the making, at least, of just.
So it
I
wasn't
want
the pandemic that led to it. You've had
no,
this idea.
No, but the pandemic gave me the time and the opportunity. I was like, if I'm going to launch this, this is probably the only time that I have available to just go for it and do it. But even during the pandemic, it took me a while to get to the point to do it because I was going through a lot personally. And then it finally happened. In February, we launched a coffee company, me and 2 other buddies of mine. And it's been really, really awesome. Mm-hmm. Also, getting into the coffee business is also really, really difficult. It's not easy because there's a million
Starbucks
other
doesn't stand a chance against Charlie Royal.
I'm coming for them.
Without a doubt.
I'm coming for them. But yeah, it's been so much fun so far. It's just been a great passion project of mine.
And it tastes good.
And it tastes really good.
Oh, it actually tastes good.
It does.
Oh, that's a good start, actually.
It doesn't taste like crap.
I'm happy to hear that.
Yeah.
So, Kellin, some of the things that you got up to in the pandemic, your movie, Paradise City, came out.
It wasn't my movie. I was just, I was
written and directed by.
I was a small piece.
But you were a little assistant in it. And then you had no cover.
Yes.
I think, who's a part of that? Pinfield was a
Pinfield,
part of that.
Alice Cooper, Gavin Rosdale from Bush, Lizzie Hale.
No big deal.
They were all really, really awesome to hang out with. Low-key, like, I had a really good time hanging out with Lizzie. And I think that Hailstorm is amazing. I would love to do a tour with those guys. Alice Cooper was the most
legend,
chill, like, nicest dude ever. Except for when we had to like announce the bands that were about to go on,
mm-hmm.
like they didn't put, geez, slurp that a little bit louder there. we'd be up in the balcony, we'd have to announce the band that was going on and say, hang on a second, and say where they were from and the song and all that stuff.
And this is all the Troubadour is where it was filmed,
yes.
right?
So we'd have to like memorize all of it on the fly and then just go right into it.
What?
And the judges would be just staring at us the whole time, and Alice would just be cold face, just like staring like that. Like, so scary.
That's not intimidating
like,
at all.
I hope I don't screw this up.
That yes. make me cry.
Then leave. Take your drink and
you,
be
But
gone.
Once again, you're always welcome back. Yes. Grab
Thanks
your
for
drink.
Hanging.
Okay, good, good.
Take
we'll
your
be
cup of wine.
Back.
Take but it somewhere else.
Your wine.
Are you drinking wine, Copeland?
Cranberry.
You're not at the age yet. You
She's
should
making up
drinking.
For not being in Vegas.
Oh, it's cranberry.
So it is
cranberry.
Wine.
Okay. Under
the bus?
Sweetberry wine.
Go find out where we're eating dinner and come back. And
see if there's any good sushi spots around here.
Yeah, I like that.
Bye. I love you. Please don't spill that.
Bye. Oh, hi.
Yeah, so No Cover was cool. Doing the TV show was cool.
And then Kellin on Ellen.
Now performing his new song, Love Race, with Kellin Quinn and Travis Barker, this is Machine Gun Kelly.
Please don't look behind us. The past is trying to catch up. Pressure's from outside us. I've got claustrophobia.
Because,
oh
my goodness.
Yes.
You and Machine Gun Kelly, you've got a history. Because you guys back in 2013, you did 2 songs together. You had Alone, which by the way,
First of all, thanks for dealing with that.
Oh, yeah, no worries. But
she's like a little Tasmanian devil, dude, just like
She'll be back.
Hey, where's your mom?
She's going to be back. But so, by the way, so Feel, I was working at Hot Topic when Feel came out.
Yeah.
So we would play that all the time in there. So it always has a special place in my heart. And then I got my start in the music industry because one day I was working at Hot Topic in Hollywood. And then Mike Shea walked in, owner of AP. And then he was just like, hey, you've got a good personality. We're thinking of kicking off a video department. Would you send me a demo video and let's see what you're like.
Is that for real? I didn't know
that.
Yeah,
so that's what happened.
That's crazy.
And then from there, I made like a fake news report on my phone to send to them. And then I'll never forget. It was either for, I think it was for Alone because it had like just dropped. And I was like, Sleeping with Sirens just came out with a new music video, blah, blah, blah. But it, obviously MGK is a part of that. You did Swing Life Away,
yes.
And then Love Race. Love Race is the track that you guys just did that you performed on Ellen. How the hell was that being on Ellen? Because it was so
terrifying.
Cool to see you there.
It was terrifying because I hadn't done like a show or anything. I think that was like the first thing I did back, and it's like, hey, we're gonna go do this song on Ellen, and I was like, okay, scary. Like, it was cool. We had like a couple run throughs and stuff, and it was a blast. I will say, if you watch the performance, I had a little bit of a hard time busting out of the Barbie box.
I saw that, and I noticed it when you were trying to grab the plastic on the side.
Dude, and they're like, it's really easy. You just rip from here. And I was like, I'm going to muddle this up. It's not going to go forward. It's going to fall back on
you're
me.
You're just
and
back
sure
there
enough,
banging.
I
rip
it
out.
Like, yeah, I was like, is there like a secret exit in
no,
case
they
I can't pull it?
Lag bolts to hold yours on.
they purposely put that thing on purpose, nice and tight.
Kel's just like kicked his or punched it and like.
Oh, he looked awesome. You looked like shit. He though looked incredible.
Yeah, I did not look cool coming out of there. So.
By the way, did you know that today is the 10-year anniversary of the music video dropping that was the anthem to so many children, with a man called Vic Fuentes, King for a Day.
Never heard of it.
It's 10 years today.
Let me kick my feet up. I've never heard of it.
That's freaking perfect.
What's this video you speak of?
So it starts off, there's a bank.
Yeah.
And you're sitting there. And then you do some stuff. But that's wild because that song popped the hell off. And I can't believe it's been a decade. And I don't see you ever needing to collab with Vic again because I don't know if you could.
We couldn't. We could not recreate that.
What about Machine Gun Kelly? Would you try to bring him back for a Sleeping with Sirens track? Because he's more in the it'd be interesting to hear him now, more of a pop punk vibe than the rap vibe that he had with Alone.
Only if he does metal screams.
Done. We're gonna make it happen. You hear that, Machine Gun Kelly? He's gonna be screaming on the next album. But that blew my mind because I checked out the video today and I looked at the date and it literally said August 6th, 2012. What year are we in?
That's crazy.
Which is
that was a
wild.
Really good time. Recording vocals for that song was a trip because I didn't have like a studio to go to at the time. I just had my homie that's like, yeah, I can record it.
Oh, really?
And he definitely should not have.
He had
like
great.
He had like a laptop from like 2004 that like barely ran and like a really shitty microphone, but somehow we got it done and I sent it to Vic and I was just waiting for a reply and just it took him like probably 4 or 5 hours to respond.
Wasn't his brother banging on the wall all night saying,
the guy that was recording
up.
It, his brother was like going to college and he was pissed because he was trying to sleep and I was
recording.
Like screaming.
Kellin's screaming all his takes.
I'm trying to study.
Yeah.
But that's crazy.
And then also a majority of the clothing that I'm wearing in the video are like Vic's because I didn't have any clothes to wear.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
He was going to go naked and they weren't into it.
What? They didn't let you go naked?
I think the only thing I'm wearing that are mine are the shoes, maybe the pants.
But definitely not the underwear. And definitely,
not the underwear.
Just
not, oh, come on, dude. Let's not. No.
Not everything
don't
else.
Look at all the fan fiction kids.
Oh,
and
yeah.
Weird ass stories.
There's a new love story coming.
I'm wearing Vic's underwear right now.
We're all wearing Vic's underwear.
Yeah.
It's great.
We always switch on.
So, Maddie, you're from Australia.
I am.
My dad's from Melbourne.
Nice.
So I have
you
dual
said it properly?
Yes. So I have dual citizenship. I got the two passports, so I always grew up going down to Australia.
Why are you still here then?
And because
yeah,
I
what
like
are you doing here?
I like getting screwed over with my Medicare, and I like all the problems that we have in this country.
Yeah.
But do you live up here now? Do you live in the States? Is it a full-time?
I've been bouncing in between, floating, obviously touring with Tonight Alive and other artists. You spend so much time in the States. It ends up being the majority of the year anyway.
Yeah.
But since the pandemic, I was in Nashville previously, and when the pandemic hit, I thought it was safest to sort of stay back in Australia.
And they Didn't they at first, they did a really good job of keeping it out of the country, but then I think all hell broke loose.
Yeah, I mean, it kind of became a prison. You couldn't get out of the country. You couldn't get in the country.
My brother was traveling there.
It's ironic because that's how it started, right?
Yeah. Yeah, it was a trip. Lockdown rules were pretty gnarly, yeah, especially in Melbourne. But you were able to travel if it was for business. So the trips I would come back here, it was all work. So work.
Mm-hmm. It is.
Yeah. So I'm still in Australia. I'm going back for a couple of weeks after this tour and then coming back out for Blue Ridge and When We Were Young Fest and everything like
that. Yeah, because so you guys are doing When We Were Young.
Yeah.
Which it's is going to be wild.
It's actually funny because Justin's in Grand Rapids.
Uh-huh.
And it takes a similar amount of time for him to get from Grand Rapids to anywhere in the States that it does me, Sydney to LA. So it's kind of hilarious.
It's the worst. I know they have direct flights, Brad. Where'd you go?
They cost a little more, though.
Yeah.
I feel like
anything out of Grand Rapids is like twice as much.
Yeah.
As well. So
move on out here to LA. We live pretty near each other, although we never hang out here.
We don't. Why is that?
But because I'm so bad at hanging with people. That's
I'm pretty
why.
Bad too. You're not alone. I'm not great at it.
And then
either.
I do this weird thing. Like anytime I hang out with like my music friends, I end up talking about stuff that I'm like, oh, I wish we caught that on camera. Like I wish that like and that's why like any interview I come to, I'm like, I can't talk to you before. And we were all outside talking. I was like, yeah. I gotta walk away.
Yeah, you just like
because something's gonna pop up that I'm not gonna like. What's coming up down the pipeline of the rest of the year? Next year, obviously, the album is it the 14th or 15th of October that it's dropping?
The 14th.
The 14th. So what else is coming up?
I mean, I think it's just that. It's the record. Everything based around that, like hitting the road, doing, I mean, I don't want to say doing a lot of touring, but we're going to be promoting the hell out of the record. I think that's the first and foremost of what we're kind of focused on. So touring.
Show wise, we got Blue Ridge, When We Were Young, we're hitting Australia in December.
Yeah, there's a big festival that you guys
just announced.
Which
is going to be epic. Couple of hometown shows.
We're trying to like NoFX backstage passport and just hit every place that we can with this record. I think.
Love that.
Trying to do some Southeast Asia. We haven't done that since like a second record. Trying to do some South America again. Yep. Be sick to get to like Africa this time.
Oh,
or
would love to.
That would be wild.
I mean, might as well.
I want to go to Antarctica.
Before the world explodes.
Yeah. No, we got close. Yeah. We got close.
On the drinking thing, by the way.
Yeah.
That was the first time I had any alcohol during the entire pandemic. So
hit you extra hard.
That was maybe like a few drinks and it just hit me like a ton of bricks. So tonight we're not going to drink at all.
We're not?
Not till after.
Okay. No, that's okay. But anything else? Anything else individually you guys are working on? We got the coffee. We got the everything else. The new album, obviously. But is that...
A lot of our focus is on this record.
Yeah.
And going in all guns blazing for it. That's where it is.
Cool.
That's it. That's all we got.
All right, get out of here. All right,
bye. Thank you so much for having us. We love you, and we think that you are amazing and wonderful.
And let's go to Tahoe.
Yes, and also everyone should check out your vlogs that you're cranking out because those are fun.
And it's also, it's a good look. This interview, let's go grab a drink.
Yeah, let's grab some drinks to celebrate no drinking for the rest of the night. But I really appreciate it, guys. Thanks for chatting. Glad we can make this work.
Thanks for having us.
And
thank
I
you.
Hope that the rest of the year.
Let's all do some ASMR. What is it?
ASMR.
And you slurp your thing real loud like you've been doing it. I'll chew some ice.
Hold on. I'm going to do it all at the same time.